What you are watching is a fireworks market explode. There were up to 300 tons of fireworks and up to 2,000 people present at the market at the time of the incident. So what was the fate of all those caught in the blasts? Tultepec is a city in Mexico, just north of Mexico City, famed for its fireworks industry. The city has a 200-year history of producing fireworks, and 65% of its inhabitants are directly or indirectly involved with the fireworks industry. Over 400 fireworks workshops and retailers are registered in the municipality. The San Pablito market often hosts fireworks vendors to sell their wares at the market for upcoming holidays. The director of the state's pyrotechnics regulator called the San Pablito fireworks market one of the safest in all of Latin America, with stalls perfectly designed and with sufficient space so that there is not a chain reaction in case of a spark. Unfortunately, it turned out that this was not entirely accurate. Such was the case on the 20th of December 2016. The market was filled with hundreds of stalls selling fireworks, with a reported 300 tons of fireworks being present across the marketplace. At around 3 p.m, an estimated 2,000 people were at the market, shopping from stall to stall and stocking up on fireworks for Christmas and New Year's. And that's when it happened. Cesar Ornelas had arrived just 10 minutes earlier with his 67-year-old father and 15-year-old son. All of a sudden, an explosion, quickly followed by another and another as fireworks detonated and set off nearby stockpiles. Very quickly, everything was catching fire. Explosions swept through the marketplace, sending stones, bricks, and debris of every kind flying in every direction. Cesar Ornelas turns to run, but is struck from behind by debris and knocked to the ground. Despite his attempts, he is unable to return to his feet, and his 15-year-old son has to drag him away. Among the fire, smoke, stampeding crowds, and dazzling explosions, they are split up from Cesar's 67-year-old father. By the time they leave the market, hours have passed. Cesar Ornelas and his son have been pelted and burned, and paramedics assessed his leg had likely been fractured by debris. They later learned the 67-year-old had also managed his way to safety, but had been hospitalized with burns and cuts. They were among the lucky ones. Initial reports said around 2 to 3 dozen had been killed in the explosions. But as the days went by, more missing people were found, and more of the injured succumbed to their injuries in hospital. Ultimately, the death toll was 42, with a further 84 injured. The market itself was almost completely leveled, with over 80% of stalls destroyed. Nearby homes were also damaged. The government of the state of Mexico promised all funeral and medical bills would be paid for by the state, while also vowing to find who was responsible. An investigation began, but to this day, the exact origin of the explosions is unknown. It's not known what set off the first blast, but that obviously caused a massive chain reaction, leading to the total devastation of the market. The market also saw fireworks-related explosions in 2005 and 2006, destroying hundreds of stalls. The San Pablito fireworks market reopened the following year in 2017, but with more safety precautions. All structures had to be built of brick and concrete to minimize debris and fire spread in case of an explosion, and fireworks had to be secured behind glass so that customers could not handle them. Customers were also limited to purchasing no more than 10 kilos of fireworks per person. Would these provisions have prevented the 2016 disaster? It's impossible to say without knowing the exact cause, but it seems likely they would have at least mitigated the widespread destruction wrought on that day.